prevented who decide, despite this warning, to risk further acquaintance with my writings, and who try to absorb them always in a spirit of impartiality and try to understand the very essence of the questions I intend to elucidate, I now wish, in view of an inherency in the human psyche whereby the good can be perceived without opposition only when a contact of mutual frankness and confidence is established, to make a sincere confession to you about the associations that arose in me and precipitated in the corresponding sphere of my consciousness the data that prompted the whole of my individuality to select as the chief hero of my writings just such an individual as is presented before your inner eyes by this same Mr. Beelzebub. I did this not without cunning. My cunning lies simply in the logical supposition that if I pay him this attention he will infallibly, as up till now I have no reason to doubt, show his gratitude by helping me in my intended writings with all the means at his command. Although Mr. Beelzebub is, as the saying goes, of a different clay, yet as I learned long ago from the treatise of the famous Catholic monk, Brother Coulon, he has a curly tail, so I, being thoroughly convinced from experience that curls are never natural but can be obtained only by various intentional manipulations, have to conclude, according to the same logic, formed in my consciousness from reading books on chiromancy, that Mr. Beelzebub must also have a good share of vanity, and will therefore find it extremely awkward not to help someone who is going to advertise his name. It is not for nothing that our incomparable teacher, Moa Nasreddin, frequently says, without greasing the palm, not only is it impossible to live tolerably anywhere but even to breathe. And another terrestrial sage, named Till Mullenspiegel, who also based his wisdom on the crass stupidity of people, has expressed the same idea in the following words. If you don't grease the